Hi, Edward. I thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. I wanted to do this quick video to give you an idea of what I'm thinking about for the second session. The first session will be about developing lean leaders at all levels in an organization, how Toyota has done it. I was working with Jeff Leiker for the last 2 years doing webinars, learning from Jeff, and we put a book together that just won a Shingo Prize. And it'll be awarded April 27th this year. So in June, I'd like to talk a little bit about that book for workshop one or keynote one. And that'll be an hour of discussing the secrets, what I've learned from an outside of Toyota perspective of what can be applied in any organization around the world. So that would be the first keynote. I'll give you a little abstract on that. On the second one, here's what I'd like to do. Now, of course, Alberta, I love. I mean, I've been there for so many years consulting, most recently with PTI and PCL Construction, GLM Tanks a while before that. There's about 300 companies that I worked with in and out with my online course and teaching them the principles of lean thinking. Now, what's next? What's after lean? After lean is about motivating people. And what's the best way to motivate people? Have them create their own goals and have them connect to the goals of the organization. Now, how do we do that? That's the key question. So what I'd like to do is give everybody an 11 by 17 piece of paper, and I'll show you a video in a workshop in Japan that we did, and I thought it was one of the best workshops I've gone through. I can do it as a keynote, and I think you'll really much enjoy it. Now, what does this mean? One piece of paper, four quadrants. I'm going to get people to fill things out about their dreams and their future. As I'm talking, I want them thinking and writing down on a piece of paper. By the time we're done, this 11 by 17 piece of paper will have two halves. One half will be about their self-actualization, what their future looks like within their company or without. Their future looks like for them. The other half will be how they contribute to society and what that means. This is the foundation of a strong goal, and then of course, I'll take it to the next step, and I'm going to say, listen, if I help you get to your future environment, what do you think it'll do if you help others do the same? Simple exercise, and I think over that 1 hour period, everybody's going to be just ecstatic. They'll be thinking about their future, their life, and what they can do with it differently than they're doing today. So I'm hoping that you love it. If you don't love it, then let's figure out something else, because I can talk on many different topics, but those are the two I'd like. Number one, developing lean leaders at all levels in any organization using the Toyota model. And number two, creating vision by a purpose-driven goal, and how do you formulate the environment around that. So I don't know exactly what to call it. I'm thinking creating purpose-driven goals might be a good topic. Thank you so much, Edward, for giving me this opportunity. And hey, I can't wait to meet you.
I am Takashi Harada, CEO of Harada Education Institute. I am very honored to have such a great opportunity. Today, I will tell you about the Harada method. I do hope the method will help you achieve your goals and get back to your nearly want in your life. From now on, let me speak in Japanese, because I speak Japanese much better than English. Okay, let's start.
Let me introduce the members.
So my dream is through family, through school system, through corporate and the companies, and develop individuals through Harada method, and becomes the individuals become self-reliant.
先ほど神戸マツダでお話ししましたように B 型のソリューション型の教育ということです。
So, since I am in the field of education, so my choice is to increase the capability of youngsters. So, the method I will choose is B, and that is a solution-oriented education.
それがまあ僕のこの教育の時代との背景にあるという感じです。
So this is the background of where we are at in this educational system.
それにこの原田メソッドを今導入しているということです
。So for that purpose, we are using Harada method.
で、日本がお手本にする国は、ドイツ、フィンランド、デンマーク、オランダ、シンガポール、マレーシア、小さな国土に資源のない国がお手本です。日本はこれから。
So for the countries we should model after, Japan should model after is Germany, Finland, Denmark, the Netherlands, Singapore, Malaysia. Those countries who have small, who are small.
And not have enough, lot of resources. やっぱりその国の生き残りをかけた教育はやっぱり
この B 型のソリューション型の教育がメインになりますね。
皆さんの国ではどうでしょうか。そんな形で教育の方は大きな転換期を迎えていますでしょうか。ちょっと逆に教えてもらいたい。
So my question is,What is your situation? What is your country's situation? Are they trying to change education in that direction or not?
No. What is the same province? Chico, that is the same province. We have
a... Mexico も同じような問題があります。
教育転換しますか。
They're trying to change the system?
Yeah.
はい、そう思います。
カナダ。
Canada?
I have no idea.
Bruce, I have a question.
Hi.
Why, if this method is so much superior, which I believe it is, why isn't it natural for people to want to do this as opposed to rote memory? Do you understand my question?
You are comparing the two educational systems?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So why is it superior?
No.
Why don't people run to do it because it's so much better than just memory?
Why do people naturally do rote memory instead of do his system if it's so much better?
So the, この solution 型の方がいいと、はい、私はそういうふうに思うんですけれども、なぜみんながどっとそっちの方に向かないんでしょうか。
それは会社とか国の、組織のですね、リーダー層の年齢の方が45歳以上の方が A 型の暗記教育しか受けていないからです。
The reason I believe is the leaders of the country or companies are older than 45 years old and they are only exposed to
I'm the bad kid in the back of the class. He wants us to be future thinkers. Is that correct?
Future. 今までの経験体験だけでは生きていけない。ですので、全く予期せぬことが目の前に起こってくるので、それに対しては待つのではなしに、自分で未来を作ってゴールを作って進んでいくという考え方をしましょう。だから、言い悪いじゃないです。
So yeah, and so what I'm saying is that we cannot proceed based on the past experiences anymore. And so we are getting into unknown territory.So we need to create our own future. So imagine the future and then approaching to that. So it's not good or bad. Workshop number one. Okay, so I want you to write down what is most important in your work and your business or whatever you do.What is the most important thing to hold you? That will be in this corner.
人は、 自分のですね、未来に対して具体的なものを追いかけながら心の喜びも求める。これをね、自己実現と言います。
Okay, self-actualization is just the two aspects. So we are creating our future, and you are trying to achieve that, and then you feel good about yourself, and that aspect of whole activity is the path to self-actualization.
そして自分以外の社会他者に対して具体的なものも生み出しながら社会他者の勇気元気も作る。これを社会貢献と言います。
Okay, this side is a contribution to the society because you are creating some tangible benefit to the other people and also creating some courage or dreams or some kind of uplifted feeling to the others.
で未来を上手に作ってこのように、4つの未来をしっかり作るとモチベーションが湧いてきて厳しい状況でも乗り越えていくんです。人は。
Okay. So by creating those futures in the four aspects, this is your future picture, right? When you are very clear about that, the people can persevere in the very tough time. Even at the very difficult time, they can persevere.If they have the clearer picture in mind.
They've told us this morning in Masda, Kobe.
Masda, Kobe, でもそこでしました。You're right.
私の時代は夢といえばここだけだったんです。
So when I was learning, I was only focusing on this part. My own goal.
今は自分の夢、心の喜び、社会他者の勇気、心の喜び、この4つすべてを夢とか未来とかゴールとか言います。
So now, when we talk about the future, the dreams and the hope, then we think of in terms of four quadrants, my tangible, intangible, then the societies or the other people's.
それで、これ言っていいですか、
はい、
ここですね。社会他者の無形のこの部分が増えれば増えるほど自分の有形のこの目標を促進します。
The more you increase the satisfaction or the benefit to this mental benefit to the other or the society, that influence your target.
で、ここ自分の精神的な喜び高まりがあると心に余裕が生まれるので、自分以外の人の具体的なものを助けたり、目がいたします。
Okay, then when you feel good about it, and this you can create this self-satisfaction, self-confidence, then you can influence others and to get more benefit.
You said influence?
Influence. Affect.
Right. 企業の理念とか、企業のクレドとかいうものを調べましたけども、組織で強い企業の理念等はここに現れてきます。
So I studied many companies' philosophies and credos and so forth. And the stronger companies, the statement appears in this quadrant.
これが今風の未来の作り方で、世界中のこれからの教育はこの4つを全て増やしなさいという方向に、まあ、大体世界中の教育は行っています。
So nowadays the education is to increase all these four quadrants and the trend of the worldwide I believe is the trend is to increase all these four quadrants.
Okay. So, I want to understand what you just said. The bottom left-hand corner, that quadrant, you said that the best companies, the most successful companies, had stronger statements in that quadrant.
ここに非常に強いステートメントを持っているのが、優秀な企業はここに非常に強いメッセージを持っているということですね。
いいですね。何しろそこに強いメッセージを与えると、これ促進します。
Okay, yes. That's what we said. And so then this excellent company have very strong messages here, and that drive the whole thing.
So is it essentially what you're saying is that these people who are highly self-actualized are giving people thinking about others and not about themselves.
ということは、非常に成長している人というのは、その自己実現ができている人というのは、自己中心的ではなくて、他の人を非常に助けるという心を持った人がいるという、そういうことをおっしゃっているんですね。
自己実現と社会性の両面発揮。
Right. And so self-actualization is this sign?And contribution to the society is this side. So both.
人はこの中のどれか一つが生まれた瞬間に実は全部四つとも生まれてるんです。それに気づいていないだけなんです。
Okay. So you can start anywhere, actually. And once you have some goal or some future you create.In one of those quadrants, actually, you are automatically creating other three. Yeah.
そういう発想で、仕事のパフォーマンスを上げることに集中すると、ものづくりの世界でいう給料ばっかり追いかけて仕事が嫌いだとか、給料だけ追いかけて自分の仕事に、価値観を感じないというのがなくなるわけなんですよ。
So, if you have this kind of thinking,Then, previously you may be thinking that I am only interested in making money as the working. We are working for money. If that is the only condition, and they say they hate the job. But if you have these all aspects in mind, and people do not have that attitude.
そのようにして、仕事が嫌いだとか、
はい、
そのものづくりの方々で自分の仕事に自信が持てないというような方に対して、これをもとに、カウンセリングしながら、そうじゃないよと、はい、あなたの仕事は誇り高きものだよと、頑張りましょうという、そういう教育ですね。
So, this education is, let's see, maybe the manufacturing, maybe the conventionally that is considered boring job or something like that.But by looking at the job and then think about in these four quadrant terms, then you can counsel these people who are saying, I don't like my job, to realize actually they are influencing others as well. Okay, let's take a break.
Okay? 20
minutes. We start 3:20?
Yes. 3:20.
Thank you very much.
Is the meaning of mandala. Man is
mandala. Mandala.
Mandala is truth.
La,
La is the owning.
で、こう、例えば例としてこれです。
So this is one example.
ボレクさん。
西洋で最高の原田メソッド指導者になるためにが真ん中に似てます。
So, to become the best Westworld Harada Method teacher is in the center.
それについて影響を及ぼす8つの柱、1、2、3、4、5、6、7、8、これを最初に考えます。
So, then around it, you think about what?
物事はその一つの目標ゴールに対して8本の柱を持っているという考え方をします。
So there are like eight pillars that support your goal. And you think about those pillars.
ここまでわかりますか?
You get it?
Yes.
Okay.
これはあの日本の今一番、まあ、多分これも今後あのアメリカの球界行くと思うんですけども、現在20歳で、
he is 20 year old young man.
でこの大谷君と言いますけども、これ私です。
me and Mr. Harada and Otani.
で彼はこのメソッドの信奉者なんです。
he is a firm believer of Harada method.
もうすぐ人類初の170キロ投げる。
He will be throwing a ball at 170 kilo an hour speed.
多分アメリカの大リーグに多分行くと思います。
So that will be get attention to the American major league.
彼は高校時代から原田メソッドやってる。
He has started using Harada method when he was high school.
彼がこれ書きました。
That is what
he's. We all have that in English.
This is cool. Yeah, it's cooler in Japanese. Yeah. This is the
mandara. So this is the mandara form, right?
で意味はこれですよね。テーマが真ん中で、そのテーマに対して、
the theme becomes in the middle.
8個のものを、まずは基本の8個を開いていくということですね。
The basic eight will be opened.
やりますか。
Okay, shall we do it?
It's a non-washable ink.
He knows.
Whoa.
Don't show me one here.
Of his head is I failed the Harada method.